Let's solve this differential equation. We have dy dx is equal to 8x to the third power times e to the negative 2y power. And we also have y of 1 is equal to 0. So be sure to solve for the constant. All right, let's go ahead, multiply dx on both sides. And you see here is the y part, right? So let's go ahead and divide both sides by e to the negative 2y. On the left-hand side, I'll put this down as 1 over e to the negative 2y. Right, before I integrate this, let me write this down as e to the positive 2y, and then this is the dy, and this is equal to 8x to the third power, and we have the dx. And now we can go ahead, integrate, isn't it? Okay, integral of e to the something, this is just a constant times y. You know this is going to be just e to the same thing, 2y, but then the derivative of 2y is 2, divided by 2, right? Because we're doing the antiderivative. 1 half e to the 2y. If you differentiate this, you'll get that back. That's great. Don't worry about the plus c. Let me just write this down as equals to, and here we have 8x to the third power. You add 1 to the power, which is x to the fourth power, right? So let me just show you guys the steps. Plus 1, which is going to give us 4. And divided by the new power, 8 divided by 4 is 2. So we have 2x to the 4th power, and right here I'm just going to put down plus c1. Maybe c1 or c2 doesn't really matter, up to you. And in this case, I can just plug in the initial condition right here and solve for the c if you would like. And I think I'll just do that. You can also solve for y first, and then at the end, solve for the c. In this case, it doesn't really matter. So let's do that right here. We know when x is equal to 1, y will be 0. So in here, we will have 1 half. E is just e, and then 2. And the y is 0. And this is equal to 2 times x is 1. So be sure when you do this kind of things, plug in the right number with the right variable. Plus, I just need a c, huh? I don't need a c1, so let me just write down c. Right, right here, this is 1 half. And e to the 0's power, right, pretty much, 2 times 0 is 0, it's just 1, so just 1 half. And 1 to the 4th power is 1, times 2 is just 2, and we add a c to that. And of course, we minus 2 on both sides, they cancel. C will be 1 half minus 4 over 2 is negative 3 over 2. That's c. So here, you know, you can just write this down as 1 half. You can just write this down as 1 half e to the 2y is equal to 2x to the 4th power, and the c is that, negative 3 over 2. And now, as I said, I would like to isolate the y. To do so, let's multiply everything by 2, so that this and that will cancel, and we will have e to the 2y, and this is equal to distribute, 2 times 2 is 4x to the 4th power, 2 times that is just minus 3. And at the end, I need to get rid of the e, the y is in the power. So let's go ahead and take the ln on both sides. And I'm not integrating, this is just a regular ln both sides situation. Parentheses, no absolute value, okay? Anyways, they cancel, and then we will have 2y equals to ln parentheses 4x to the 4th power minus 3. Finally, I multiply by both sides by 1 half, and we're done. So I'll write this down nicely for you guys. Y is equal to 1 half ln parentheses 4x to the 4th power minus 3. This is it.